What is up, guys? Jimmy or Chaos, welcome to Sunday's Top 10, and today we're going to do it a little different because of all the hype and everything that's been going on with Infinite Warfare and COD 4 Remastered. We are going to do a top 10 things that you guys feel must be in Infinite Warfare for it to be a success. We'll have a couple honorable mentions at the end, and drop a like if you even just have a little bit of that spring COD hype now that we know about Infinite Warfare and COD 4 Remastered. Let's jump right into this. And at number 10 from Russell's Lugget, he's just going to get right to it, guys. No supply drops. Hashtag Chaos Top 10. Now, I know most people will say no supply drops. They need to do that to make it a success. But I don't want to be the bearer of bad news, but I highly doubt that there will be no supply drops. As a matter of fact, if I was a betting man, I would put everything I had on the notion that they will have supply drops. Now, how they handle those supply drops is going to be the question that everybody is asking. We'll have to wait and see. I understand where you're coming from, but I don't think you are going to get that one. Coming in at number 9 from Mr. Connor Master 7. Very cool, unique co-op mode. Maybe actual aliens or zombie type things. Just something people will crave for Chaos Top 10. Now, I totally agree with this. I think they really need to knock it out of the park with the extra bonus mode. Treyarch not only has the multiplayer, but they are carried by the zombie community as well. And it gives way more of a longevity playability factor to the game. And Infinity Ward has lacked that. So I think that's a very, very good suggestion. Coming in at number 8 from GavmanHD. Hashtag Chaos Top 10. A good color palette. The game needs to look great. G-R-A-T, I love it. Or else it will end up like Ghosts, dull and boring to look at. Now, Call of Duty Ghosts was a depressing game to look at. It was very drab, it was very gray, it was very dull. You're watching gameplay here on Nuketown and Black Ops 3, and you guys see the difference. I mean, it's vibrant, it's alive, and I really think Infinity Ward needs to take a page out of Treyarch when it comes to the color palette and really amp things up. Now, I know if it's a dark setting game or whatever, you're going for that feel, but you really need vibrant colors to keep things going. Coming in at number 7 from I Am Hunterific. Hashtag Infinite Warfare needs to have good killstreaks. Every game IW gets progressively worse at killstreaks. Hashtag Chaos Top 10. I agree with this totally, and the culmination of that was Call of Duty Ghosts, and that was the probably worst batch of killstreaks that we've ever seen in a game. I would rather have 357 from COD 4 than the stuff that we had from Call of Duty Ghosts. And I think that's going to be very, very important to them to get that right. Go back to the days of Modern Warfare 2 type killstreaks, I hope. That's what I'm hoping, but that is a very, very good suggestion. Hunter, coming in at number 6, from Pure Acking, Assing? Pure Assing? Hashtag Infinite Warfare needs a good campaign like the Modern Warfare, Modern Warfare series. My apologies. Hashtag Chaos Top 10. Now, I agree that they need a good campaign. Campaigns kick ass and they're really fun to play. I don't think that's going to be a problem. I don't really think we've had a bad campaign ever with Call of Duty. Yeah, now that I think about it, I really don't think we have. Even Call of Duty Ghosts, the multiplayer had its issues, but the campaign was fun. The campaign was riveting. There was a lot going on to it, and I enjoyed it. So I don't think Infinity Ward is going to have an issue giving us a good campaign, especially with the teasers we've seen for all the Settlement Defense Force and all that stuff. I think it's going to be solid. Coming in at number 5 from Duke Reverse. Old game modes like Infected, Drop Zone, and Team Tactical. Hashtag Chaos Top 10. I don't understand why stuff like that's not in every game. You want, as a developer and Activision, you want people to be playing your game all the time. Give them as many options as you can to do that. They don't want to play multiplayer for 30 days straight. They want to take a break, go play some party games, some Infected, and then come back to it. So I think that is a great suggestion, and hopefully they listen to that one. Coming in at number 4 from Aust Mueller. Hands down, need a trading system for anything in supply drops. Austin understands there's probably going to be supply drops. Trading system, community platform, marketplace. Come on, Infinity Ward, watch this video, make it happen, make it right, make them have some value. And man, I can't, that's the biggest news to me. The biggest news I am waiting for down the line is what's going on with supply drops, and will there be some type of online marketplace that creates value for the guns? It's going to be interesting to see what happens. Coming in at number 4 from Timothy Can't Read. The classic create a class system. Since COD 4 Remastered is most likely a thing, it is a thing, buddy. It seems like a good fit. Hashtag Chaos Top 10. I don't know what you mean by classic create a class. If you're saying COD 4 create a class for Infinite Warfare, I'm going to disagree with you. COD 4 create a class for COD 4 is great, but I'm all about a pick 10 class. I like it. I mean, there's nothing wrong with it to me. I don't want the Call of Duty or create a class. I hope not. So we'll have to wait and see, but I like the pick the point system type create a class we've seen from like Treyarch and their games. That's just me. You guys can let me know if you agree or disagree. Coming in at number 3 from Midnight, excellent maps. Just simple to the point, excellent maps. We've grown accustomed to getting good maps from Treyarch. It's been a while for Infinity Ward. Once again, they are just judged off their recent performance of Call of Duty Ghosts, and the maps were not that great. There were some fun ones. There was a couple. But when you think about it as a whole, you don't think excellent. So I think they could take a page out of Treyarch, go with the classic three-laners, and that would be the safest route to go. That's just my opinion. Coming in at number 2 from Diarol, cosmetics only supply drops. Bring the DLC guns to the season pass holders. Basically, anything that would be value needs to come to the season pass holder. I get it. I totally understand. And just throw cosmetics in that don't have any changes or stat changes or anything like that for the supply drops. I'm sure you are not in the minority when it comes to that suggestion. But coming in at number 1 from Zach Mac Morris, best Twitter name so far today, the weapon balancing in Modern Warfare 2. Every gun was good in that game. I agree, there was some strong ones, but there was a lot of usable weapons in Modern Warfare 2. And I think every developer starts out trying to get balanced guns. I think it's way trickier than that, and they find that out once the game launches, but I'm sure they are focused on that and will try to make sure that happens. Couple honorable mentions for you guys. QB-Doo, Pro Perks, they were the best and we need them back. I agree. I think Pro Perks would be a change, and I think it would be fun to go after and have to level up to get your Pro Perks. That's just me, I could be wrong. And that is it, guys. Let me know if you have any suggestions on what Infinite Warfare needs to do to be a success. Drop a like on the video if you guys would. I'll be back later with another one, and I'll see you later.